In the United Kingdom, access by the general public to firearms is tightly controlled by law, which is much more restrictive than the minimum rules required by the European Firearms Directive, but it is less restrictive in Northern Ireland. The country has one of the lowest rates of gun homicides in the world. There were 0.05 recorded intentional homicides committed with a firearm per 100,000 inhabitants in the 5 years to 2011, 15 to 38 people per annum. Gun homicides accounted for 2.4% of all homicides in the year 2011. There is some concern over the availability of illegal firearms. Office for National Statistics figures show 7,866 offenses in which firearms were involved in the year ending March 2015, 2% up on the previous year and the first increase in 10 years. Of these, 19 were fatalities, 10 fewer than the previous year and the lowest since records began in 1969. There was a further rise to 8,399 in the year ending March 2016, the highest number in 4 years, but significantly lower than the all-time high of 24,094 in 2003-04. 26 resulted in fatal injuries. Members of the public may own sporting rifles and shotguns, subject to licensing, but handguns were effectively banned after the Dunblane School massacre in 1996, with the exception of Northern Ireland. Dunblane was the UK's first and only school shooting. There has been one spree killing since Dunblane, in June 2010, involving a shotgun and a .22 caliber rifle, both legally held. Prior to Dunblane, though, there has only been one mass shooting carried out by a civilian in the entire history of Great Britain, which took place in Hungerford on August 19, 1987. Police in the United Kingdom, aside from Northern Ireland, are not routinely armed. Fatal shootings of police are extremely rare. There were 3 in England and Wales in the 11-year period from 2000-01 to 2010-11. Armed response units are available to deal with incidents, and as of the March 31, 2017, there were 6,278 armed officers serving in territorial police forces in England and Wales. Shooting sports. Shooting sports split into different categories in the UK between target shooting, clay pigeon shooting, pest control, and hunting. Sports, once a relatively elitist activity, have become far more popular in modern times amongst people from all walks of life. A lot of current civilian rifle clubs trace their history to the volunteers of the middle 19th century, raised locally among the gentry to afford some readiness to counter the constant threat of invasion by Napoleon III. These volunteer organizations and military shooting clubs developed over time into civilian clubs as the volunteer organizations were incorporated into the territorial army. The rise in popularity in the civilian clubs started in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, especially full-bore rifle events sponsored by the military and National Rifle Association of the United Kingdom to improve the general standard of marksmanship under the auspices of Defence of the Realm. Impact of firearm legislation. In 2012, the Home Office reported that, in 2010-11, firearms were involved in 11,227 recorded offences in England and Wales, the 7th consecutive annual fall. Firearms statistics in England and Wales include airguns and imitation guns, which make up a high proportion of these recorded offences, see under Firearms Crime below. However, this was a return to the levels seen prior to the legislation in 1997. Firearms offences almost doubled in the 8 years following handguns being made illegal. Fully automatic, submachine guns, etc., are prohibited weapons and require explicit permission from central government to permit ownership. Generally, such permits are not available to private citizens. Semi-automatic rifles over .22 in, 5.6 millimeters, and pistols are similarly prohibited, although there are exceptions for short-barreled breech-loading semi-automatic and revolver pistols for use for the humane dispatch of animals, classed under Section 5. There are also very limited exceptions for pistols both to preserve firearms of historic or technical interest, classed as Section 7 firearms, and to enable use by elite sports teams. Semi-automatic shotguns are restricted to a magazine capacity of no more than 2 shot and is held under Section 2 of the Firearms Act, although a multi-shot shotgun can be owned under Section 1, Restricted Firearms and Ammunition, of the Firearms Act. Where the term multi-shot is used, this refers to either a semi-automatic or pump-action shotgun with no restriction on magazine capacity. All other rifles and their ammunition are permitted with no limits as to magazine size, to include target shooting, hunting, and historic and muzzle-loading weapons, as well as long-barreled breech-loading pistols with a specific overall length, but not for self-defense. However, if a homeowner is threatened, they may be used in self-defense, so long as the force is reasonable. Shotgun possession and use is controlled, and even low-power air rifles and pistols, while permitted, are controlled to some extent. A firearm certificate issued by the police is required for all weapons and ammunition except air weapons of modest power, of muzzle energy not over 12 FTLBF, 16J, for rifles, and 6 FTLBF, 8.1J, for pistols. Shotguns with a capacity of 3 rounds or less, up to guns with a magazine holding no more than 2 rounds, in addition to one in the chamber, are subject to less stringent licensing requirements than other firearms and require a shotgun certificate. Shotguns with higher capacity require a firearm certificate. Possession of a live firearms round can lead to severe penalties. Live firearms ammunition, other than most shotgun ammunition, may only be purchased and possessed with the authority of a firearm certificate. Shotgun cartridges can be possessed by anybody over the age of 15, but no license is required to hold such ammunition so long as the cartridges contain 5 or more shots. However, a license covering possession of a firearm capable of firing shotgun ammunition is required for purchase. While Scotland has had its own parliament, Holyrood, since the Scotland Act 1998, power to legislate on firearms was reserved to the Westminster Parliament, which led to tensions between the British and Scottish parliaments, with the Scottish government wanting to enact stricter laws. In Northern Ireland, possessing a firearm with a firearm certificate issued by the Police Service of Northern Ireland is legal. Firearms control laws in Northern Ireland are primarily regulated by the Firearms, Northern Ireland, Order 2004, slightly different from the law in Great Britain. Gun licensing and legislation. The legislation is interpreted in different ways by different police authorities. For example, some authorities allow clubs to possess long-barreled pistols for members to use, and allow members who own them to allow other members to use them. Other authorities place the condition that only the owner may fire them. It is considered an offense for anyone else to even touch the firearm. This effectively requires members each to own their own pistol. In 2002, the Home Office issued firearms law guidance to the police, a 212-page long document. A revised version was published in October 2013. In 2012, the British Shooting Sports Council believed that the law needed to be consolidated, but did not call for a review. Classifications of firearms. Rifles. UK law defines a rifle as a rifled firearm with a barrel longer than 30 cm, 12 in, and a total length longer than 60 cm, 24 in, that does not fall under the classification of long-barreled revolver or pistol. Single shot, bolt action, martini action, lever action, also called under lever action, and revolver rifles and carbines are permitted, with certificate, in any caliber. Self-loading, also known as semi-automatic, or pump-action rifles are only permitted in .22 rimfire caliber. Pistols. The 1997 law did not ban pistols as such and was drafted in terms of small firearms. 3.2 British law defines a pistol as a firearm with a barrel shorter than 30 cm, 12 in, or a total length of less than 60 cm, 24 in. This definition encompasses revolvers, revolving pistols. Only muzzle-loading pistols, including muzzle-loading revolvers, are permitted. In practice, all such firearms use black powder, a Class 1 explosive, as the propellant. Small quantities of muzzle-loading pistols and revolvers in various calibers, which comply with the regulations, are manufactured. All other pistols are prohibited in Great Britain, with some exceptions such as pistols used for the humane dispatch of injured animals, such as deer, and some historical firearms. Specific models of blank firing starting pistol that are readily convertible to fire live ammunition can also be banned. The Bruny Olympic .380 BBM blank firing revolver was banned in 2010 on evidence that it was being illegally converted. Long-barreled revolvers and pistols. Long-barreled revolvers and long-barreled pistols meeting specified criteria are not classified as small, and hence prohibited, firearms. It is legal, with a firearm certificate, to possess them. The barrel must be at least 30 centimeters, 12 in, long, and the firearm at least 60 centimeters, 24 in, long, which can be achieved by having a permanently attached extension to the grip or butt of the firearm. Long-barreled single-shot firearms of any caliber, and semi-automatic pistols of .22 rimfire calibers, are permitted with FAC. Target pistols. Aside from special temporary exemptions for major events such as the 2012 Olympics, pistol shooting for sporting purposes has been effectively banned since 1997. As a result, the GB pistol squad has to practice abroad. A few models of single-shot .22 caliber free pistol, as used in the 50M Olympic free pistol match, have been produced to meet the long-barreled pistol conditions. Some free pistols have removable stabilizer bars extending backwards to improve stability. The UK legal models have been made with non-removable stabilizers to extend the dimensions, instead of contrived and non-functional grip extensions. Examples are the single-shot Pardini K22 long arm and the Westlake Britarms long pistol, a permitted .22 LR5 shot semi-automatic pistol. Shotguns. Single, double, or triple-barreled shotguns, or those with a lever action or pump action, or semi-automatic and fixed magazine capacity of no more than 3.2 in the magazine and 1 in the chamber, cartridges are permitted on a shotgun certificate. Shotguns with a detachable magazine or larger fixed magazine are permitted on a Section 1 firearm certificate. Types of shotgun ammunition, such as solid slugs, can only be bought following the grant of an FAC, firearm certificate. There is no limit on the number of guns or amount of ammunition that a SGC, shotgun certificate, holder can acquire or possess at one time, although each shotgun is recorded on the certificates. Air guns. Air guns are firearms like any other according to the definition given in the Firearms Act 1968 at Section 57, 1. However, they are exempt from the requirement that a firearm certificate or shotgun certificate need be obtained to possess or acquire them, provided that they meet certain limits as to their power. Air pistols with a muzzle energy not exceeding 6 foot-pounds force, 8.1 joules, and other air guns with a muzzle energy not exceeding 12 FTLBF, 16J, do not require a certificate and may be acquired, purchased, and possessed by anyone over the age of 18 and who is not a prohibited person as specified in Section 21 of the Act, which relates to persons previously convicted of crime. The UK Violent Crime Reduction Act 2006 controls online or mail order sales of air guns by way of trade or business. Transactions must be finalised face-to-face, although the contract of sale may take place at a distance. The air gun may be sent by the seller to a registered firearms dealer, who will act as the seller's agent in the sale, from whom the gun may be collected by the purchaser. The same act introduced the requirement that a person selling air guns or ammunition for air guns by way of trade or business be a registered firearms dealer. It is not an offence for a private individual to sell an air gun to another person as long as both parties are not legally barred from possessing air guns and the transaction does not constitute a business activity. It became a crime to fire an air weapon beyond the boundary of any premises without the occupier's permission, and increased the lower age limit for buying or possessing an air weapon to 18 years. From February 10, 2011, the Crime and Security Act 2010, S.46, made it an offence, for a person in possession of an air weapon to fail to take reasonable precautions to prevent any person under the age of 18 from having the weapon with him. Any person who is in a building or is on land as a trespasser whilst having a firearm with them commits the offence of trespassing with a firearm. It is immaterial whether or not they have any ammunition with them at the time or whether they actually intend to use it at the place in which they were trespassing. Ammunition. Explosive, incendiary, noxious, biological, chemical, and armor-piercing ammunition types are prohibited for civilians. Expanding ammunition is not only permitted but a legal requirement for deer stalking. Holders of a FAC for the purpose of game, shooting or deer stalking are required to have authorization to acquire and possess expanding ammunition noted on it. The amount of ammunition allowed for purchase and possession is determined by conditions stated on an FAC. Prohibited firearms. The following are generally prohibited: fully automatic or burst fire weapons, which may include some air guns; semi-automatic or pump-action rifles that fire center-fire ammunition, e.g. Colt AR-15, L1A1. Cartridge ammunition handguns, regardless of caliber. Firearms disguised as another item, e.g. walking sticks, mobile telephones, etc. Rockets and mortars. Air guns chambered for self-contained gas cartridges. Existing owners prior to January 20, 2004 were allowed ownership subject to obtaining a firearm certificate. Any weapon of whatever description designed or adapted for the discharge of any noxious liquid, gas, or other thing. This would generally include stun guns, or electric shock devices, CS gas, tear gas, OC spray, pepper spray, etc. Cattle prods would not generally be included, but it would depend on the type. Firearms which previously fell into a prohibited category, but have been converted to an otherwise permitted form. For example, a pistol which is adapted by permanently fitting a 60cm, 24-inch, long smoothbore barrel to it does not thereby become permitted. 2.29. Firearm licensing. With a few specialized exceptions, all firearms in the United Kingdom must be licensed on either a 5-year firearm certificate, FAC, or a shotgun certificate, SGC, issued by the police for the area in which they normally reside. Each certificate can list multiple firearms, and the certificate remains valid until expiry even if all the listed firearms were subsequently banned. Shotguns, Section 2 firearms under the 1968 Act as amended, are defined in UK law as smoothbore firearms with barrels not shorter than 24 inches, 61 centimeters, and a bore not larger than 2 inches, 5.1 centimeters, in diameter, no revolving cylinder, and either no magazine or a non-detachable magazine that is not capable of holding more than 2 cartridges, plus 1 in the chamber. Shotguns with higher capacity require a firearm certificate. Shotguns thus defined are subject to a less rigorous certification process than for the full FAC. An applicant is not required by law to make a good case for being granted a certificate, but the police may withhold a certificate if they consider that the applicant does not have satisfactory security in place, or granting it would constitute a danger to public safety or to the peace. A certificate holder may possess as many shotguns as can be securely stored. When applying for a firearm certificate, justification must be provided to the police for each firearm, and they are individually listed on the certificate by type, caliber, and serial number. A shotgun certificate similarly lists type, caliber, and serial number, but permits possession of as many shotguns as can be safely accommodated. To gain permission for a new firearm, a variation must be sought, for a fee, unless the variation is made at the time of renewal, or unless it constitutes a one-for-one replacement of an existing firearm that will be disposed of. The certificate also sets out, by caliber, the maximum quantities of ammunition someone may possess at any one time, and is used to record ammunition purchases, except where ammunition is bought to use immediately on a range under S11 or S15 of the Firearms Act. To obtain a firearm certificate, the police must be satisfied that a person has good reason to own each firearm, and that they can be trusted with it without danger to the public safety or to the peace. Under Home Office guidelines, firearm certificates are only issued if a person has legitimate sporting, collecting, or work-related reasons for ownership. Since 1968, self-defense has not been considered a valid reason to own a firearm. The current licensing procedure involves, positive verification of identity, two referees of verifiable good character who have known the applicant for at least 2 years, and who may themselves be interviewed and/or investigated as part of the certification, approval of the application by the applicant's own family doctor, an inspection of the premises and cabinet where firearms will be kept and a face-to-face interview by a firearms inquiry officer, FIO, also known as a firearms liaison officer, FLO. A thorough background check of the applicant is then made by special branch on behalf of the firearms licensing department. Only when all these stages have been satisfactorily completed will a license be issued, which must be renewed every 5 years. Any person who has been sentenced to between 3 months and 3 years in prison is automatically prohibited from possessing firearms, including airguns, and ammunition for 5 years from release. A person who has been sentenced to more than 3 years is prohibited for life. Application may be made to a court to reverse these prohibitions, and this is likely to be successful in relation to convictions for crimes which do not relate to a person's fitness to possess firearms. Similarly, persons applying for licenses with recent, serious mental health issues will also be refused a certificate. Any person holding a firearm or shotgun certificate must comply with strict conditions regarding such things as safe storage. These storage arrangements are checked by the police before a license is first granted, and on every renewal of the license. In the case of a firearm certificate, the issuing police force may impose additional conditions over and above the statutory ones. However, any condition appended to a certificate must be reasonable and must not be of such a restrictive nature as would amount to a constructive refusal to grant the certificate by making use so unlikely as to be practically impossible. Failure to comply with any of these conditions can result in criminal prosecution, resulting in a prison sentence of up to 6 months. Revocation of the certificate is also possible, depending upon the nature of the breach. A visitor's permit is available for possession of firearms without certificate by visitors to the UK. The penalty for possession of any type of firearm without a certificate is a maximum of 14 years in prison and an unlimited fine. The penalty for Section 5 categories of firearm is subject to a mandatory minimum of 5 years. Although the sentencing judge has discretion to depart from the minimum sentence if there are exceptional circumstances. The Violent Crime Reduction Act 2006 increased restrictions on the use, possession, sale, and manufacture of both airguns and imitation firearms. Northern Ireland. More than 100,000 people in Northern Ireland, approximately 5.7% of the population, own firearms, having 380,000 among them. Gun control laws in Northern Ireland are less restrictive than gun laws in Great Britain due to the Good Friday Agreement, allowing Northern Ireland to govern itself and pass less restrictive laws. Gun laws in Northern Ireland are primarily affected by the Firearms, Northern Ireland, Order 2004. Under the new law, first-time buyers will be required to demonstrate they can be trusted with the firearm. It will be up to firearms dealers selling the products to tell new buyers, and those upgrading their firearms, about the safety procedures. Firearm possessors in Northern Ireland must not transport their firearms to Great Britain. All gun owners in Northern Ireland are required to apply for a firearm certificate to possess firearms. Permits are normally issued to anyone who has good reason to possess firearms, such as target shooting, hunting, and personal protection. Northern Ireland is the only part of the United Kingdom where personal protection is accepted as a legitimate reason to obtain and own a firearm, and is the only part of the United Kingdom or Ireland where handguns are permitted. Semi-automatic rifles are only permitted when chambered in .22 caliber, with certain exceptions. Handguns and shotguns are permitted in any caliber. There is no limit on magazine capacity for rifles and handguns, and the magazine limit for shotguns is 2 rounds. Also, carrying a firearm in plain view in a public place is allowed without a permit. Open carry of handguns is not common. However, in the countryside, people will often open carry loaded rifles and shotguns. A firearm certificate for a personal protection weapon will only be authorized where the police service of Northern Ireland deems there is a verifiable specific risk to the life of an individual and that the possession of a firearm is a reasonable, proportionate, and necessary measure to protect their life. Permits for personal protection also allow the holder to carry their firearms concealed. They may also allow the holder to possess fully automatic weapons and center-fire semi-automatics in some instances. Scotland. Gun laws in Scotland differ in some details from those in the rest of the UK. However, in terms of licensing they are, currently, identical to the rest of Great Britain. A firearms certificate is required to purchase firearms, and a separate shotgun certificate is required for shotguns. The guiding laws for firearms in Scotland are the Firearms, Scotland, Rules 1989 and the Firearms Act, 1968. All handguns, semi-automatic and pump-action non-rimfire rifles are prohibited. A few pistols are licensed on a firearm certificate for exactly the same reasons as the rest of Great Britain. There are only 566 licensed handgun owners in Scotland. Air weapon licensing. In 2006, Glasgow politician Tommy Sheridan of the political party Solidarity launched a consultation to restrict possession of air guns, highlighting recent cases including the death of toddler Andrew Morton, but the Scottish Parliament did not have the power to ban air guns at the time, so any measures would have needed to be formally approved by Westminster. Around this time, the media gave some exposure to growing public desire to have air guns banned or regulated, particularly from the parents of a child that died after being struck in the head by a pellet in Easter House, a suburb of East Glasgow. The child was said to have had a skull only 2 millimeters thick at the point of impact. MSPs such as Kenny McCaskill have claimed Scotland has a problem with air gun violence. However, official figures show that out of the estimated 500,000 air guns in Scotland, there were only 195 offences, a ratio of less than 0.04%. Not all of these offences have been linked to violence, with many being minor. The Commission on Scottish Devolution, when implemented, gave the Scottish Parliament powers to regulate air guns. On December 14, 2012, a consultation was launched to investigate proposals for licensing air weapons in Scotland. The Scottish Cabinet Secretary for Justice forward in the consultation paper, titled Proposals for Licensing Air Weapons in Scotland, stated that the regional government not intend to ban air weapons outright, but not think that it is appropriate in our modern Scotland that there can be up to 500,000 unregistered, uncontrolled, and often forgotten firearms. However, air weapons are not considered firearms under the law, in circulation. It stated an aim to ensure that only those people with a legitimate reason for owning and using an airgun should have access to them in the future, and that they are properly licensed and accounted for. In 2011-12 there were 195 offences involving air weapons in Scotland, compared to 3,554 in England and Wales. The consultation closed in March 2013 with 1,101 responses, 87% of which were opposed to the principle of licensing air weapons. In July 2013, Shooting UK reported that a petition against the introduction of air weapon licensing in Scotland had so far gained 14,193 signatures. Petition founder Dave Ewing, who was due to appear before the Scottish Parliament's Public Petitions Committee in September, was reported as being pleased with the response to date, but that it is very important for people to continue signing and showing support, as the shooting community must pull together to defend our rights. Every single law-abiding person that is deterred from shooting due to overly restrictive laws or unfair financial hurdles weakens community. BASC and the Scottish Gamekeepers Association, SGA, is also supporting the petition, with the SGA's George MacDonald saying, "Responsible people object to having legislation forced upon them where there is no demonstrable need." The statistics for misuse of an airgun are very low. As of December 31, 2016, it is a requirement to hold an airgun certificate in Scotland to possess a sub-12 ft/lb air rifle or sub-6 ft/lb air pistol. There are some exceptions for current FAC and SGC holders in that they may hold an air rifle on their current certificate and apply to add it/them when next renewing their FAC or SGC. Firearms legislation in the United Kingdom. Many laws and amendments governing possession and use of firearms have been enacted over the years. See Firearms Act No. United Kingdom for a more complete list. Following the assassination of William of Orange in 1584 with a concealed Wheelock pistol, Queen Elizabeth I, fearing assassination by Roman Catholics, banned possession of Wheelock pistols near a royal palace in 1594. There were growing concerns in the 16th century over the use of guns and crossbows. Four acts were imposed to restrict their use. The Bill of Rights restated the ancient rights of the people to bear arms by reinstating the right of Protestants to have arms after they had been illegally disarmed by James II. It follows closely the Declaration of Rights made in Parliament in February 1689. The Bill of Rights text declares that the subjects which are Protestants may have arms for their defence suitable to their conditions and as allowed by law. Whereas the late King James II, by the assistance of divers evil counselors, judges, and ministers, employed by him, did endeavor to subvert and extirpate the Protestant religion, and the laws and liberties of this kingdom, b. why assuming and exercising a power of dispensing with and suspending of laws, and the execution of laws, without consent of Parliament, b. why causing several good subjects, being Protestants, to be disarmed, at the same time when Papists were both armed and employed contrary to law, a.l.l. which are utterly and directly contrary to the known laws and statutes and freedom of this realm. The said Lords Spiritual and Temporal and Commons, pursuant to their respective letters and elections, being now assembled in a full and free representative of this nation, taking into their most serious consideration the best means for attaining the ends aforesaid, do in the first place, as their ancestors in like case have usually done, for the vindicating and asserting their ancient rights and liberties, declare, that the subjects which are Protestants may have arms for their defence, suitable to their condition, and as allowed by law. The rights of English subjects and, after 1707, British subjects, to possess arms was recognised under English common law. Sir William Blackstone's commentaries on the laws of England were highly influential and were used as a reference and textbook for English common law. In his commentaries, Blackstone described the right to arms. The fifth and last auxiliary right of the subject, that I shall at present mention, is that of having arms for their defence, suitable to their condition and degree, and such as are allowed by law. Which is also declared by the same statute IW and MST 2. C. 2 and is indeed a public allowance, under due restrictions, of the natural right of resistance and self-preservation, when the sanctions of society and laws are found insufficient to restrain the violence of oppression. Formerly, this same British common law applied to the UK and Australia, and until 1791 to the colonies in North America that became the United States. The right to keep and bear arms had originated in England during the reign of Henry II with the 1181 Assize of Arms, and developed as part of common law. After the Jacobite rebellions.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.